Oh, wait, I have a question for you. Are there things on your to-do list that you're procrastinating to do and watching this YouTube video instead?
Well, then keep watching this video till the end because I will share 5 steps that you can use and beat procrastination for good.
Hey everyone, my name is Shiv. I am a Sydney-based sales professional, a public speaker, and a self-help content creator. I welcome you to my YouTube channel where I share my uncooked thoughts on personal development, leadership, sales, communication skills. So if you're new to my channel, consider subscribing it as I will be creating more content in the coming days. Alright, with that out of the picture, let's get into the video, which is 5 tips to beat procrastination. Before that, let me just tell you that I faked the paper punch I did in the beginning of this video, but the 5 tips I'm gonna share are as real as they get. So let's start with the number 1 tip that you need to do, which is write SMART goals. Maybe you have tried writing goals in the past, but I want you to give a try of writing SMART goals. Here, the SMART stands for specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time bounded. Now, let me give an example of one of the SMART goals that I wrote down and we will break it together. So my current goal is to have a 5 kilograms lean bulk by the end of this year, that is 31st December 2021. It is very specific, as in it is clearly defined. It is measurable because I can step on a weight scale and know how much I exactly weigh. It is attainable because in 3 months, gaining 5 kilos is not that hard. It is relevant because it's from my personal life. I want to get healthier. I want to be more fit. Now, when you are writing a goal, make sure that you don't have a goal of somebody else because that is not relevant to you. Really figure out what do you want, and that is how you can stop procrastination and achieve those goals. The 5th one, it is time bounded, as in it has a deadline, which is 31st December 2021. All right, tip number 2, 1% efforts mindset. Let me tell you a trick that you can use to hack your mind, hack your brain, and be more productive and beat procrastination. It is taking very small actions, which is you putting in 1% effort to complete that bigger task. Now, let me give an example. You want to go out for a 5 kilometer run. Now, that is a very big task, right? It is not easy to run 5 kilometers, especially if you haven't been working out and you're procrastinating. What you can do to hack your mind to go out of the house and be in the park is just think, I have to put on my socks and running shoes. That's it. So today's task is to just put on the socks and your running shoes. Of course, it's a very basic example. When you have put on those shoes, you will ask yourself, you know, might as well just go out, maybe just for a walk of 1 kilometer instead of running 5 kilometers. So you take the second step. Now, once you're out of your house, there are more chances that you will finish that task. Another example is, imagine that your room is a mess. And my room was a mess just a couple of days ago. So what I did was, I thought, okay, I'm just gonna clean one specific corner of my room, that's it. Once I started cleaning that one small corner of my room, you know, I was like, okay, let me just do the whole room. So you can take these 1% small efforts, and then once your foot is in the door, once your hands are dirty, you're more likely to finish the whole of the task. Let me share a very powerful method of self-talk that can help you to take that action. Brian Tracy, the author of Eat the Frog, mentioned using the phrase, do it now. So once you're procrastinating to do something, if you change the self-talk and you use this phrase out aloud, do it now, over a period of time, maybe you will be pulled into doing that action. You can also use Mel Robbins' 5-second rules, which is equally interesting, where you count down from 5 and you have to take action in those 5 seconds. Now, using these tools will help you to take actions and trick your mind while you want to procrastinate the task. Tip number 3, the Pareto principle. There was an Italian economist, Vilfredo Pareto, who found out that in Italy, 80% of the land was owned by 20% of the population, which gave birth to the Pareto principle, which is also applicable in economics, sports, marketing. Of course, it's not always 80-20, it could be 70-30, it could be, you know, 90-10, but usually only a few of the tasks will bring the most of the result in your life. So you can use this to beat procrastination by doing the most important task first, and only then you complete the smaller task later on. Why is this? Because once you do the, you know, seemingly easy but not important task, you get this false sense of achievement and you keep putting off the bigger important task at the end of the day, and then you think, I'll do it tomorrow. So start by eating the ugliest frog first, which means Brian Tracy said that if you have a few frogs in front of you and you have to eat them, start by eating the ugliest frog first, because then you're done with it. You know, it will be very easy for you to keep going on. It's a very weird example, but it's a great book to read. It's called Eat the Frog by Brian Tracy. Tip number four, surround yourself with achievers and action takers. Now, this might be new for you, but let me break down why this is so important. You know, you all have heard the saying, you're the product of five people that you surround yourself with. But I don't think we take it seriously. And this is one of those underrated things that we need to put more energy and efforts in. That is finding people that we want to network with, finding people who are doing better than us and learning from them, being in their network. Your network is your net worth. What will happen is that if you surround yourself with people who are taking actions, their energy and passion will rub off on you. And you would want to fit in that social group, and you will start taking actions, being inspired by the people who are taking actions. If you surround yourself with people who procrastinate or who, you know, justify not taking actions, that will help you to reinforce your own inability to take actions. So surround yourself with action takers, achievers, and see your productivity skyrocketing. Tip number five, turn off the distractions. Multiple researchers have shown that we are more productive when we focus at one task at a time. Our brain cannot really process a lot of things happening at the same time. And that is the reason you should be focusing on one task and getting rid of all the distractions. We are living in a digital age where we get bombarded with informations, you know, be it the emails that you're getting, be it the notifications on your social media, all this content that is floating around in the internet on Netflix. We are just so distracted all the time. But if you want to be more productive, you have to get rid of these distractions. So turn off your notifications, put your phone on airplane mode, or you can also use the Pomodoro technique, which is 25 minutes of concentrated work and then 5 minutes of break, and then again 25 minutes of focused work, and then you take 5 minutes break. You can do this multiple times and divide your schedule daily routine in blocks where you use Pomodoro techniques, and you can't use your phone for those 25 minutes. That's how you can get rid of the distractions. So these were my 5 tips to beat procrastination. Of course, this is not an exhaustive list, and I just share the 5 things that have been working in my life, and in no way I'm saying that I never procrastinate. Quite frankly, this video itself took a few weeks of procrastination for me to upload, but I've become more productive and efficient in other areas of my life using the 5 strategies I shared in this video. I want to end this video by giving you all a task. Okay, this is a task to everyone watching, and the catch is you cannot procrastinate to complete this task. Are you ready? Okay, your task is to hit that like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Do not procrastinate, because I will be creating more content in the coming days on sales, self-growth, personal development, leadership, and communication skills. So if you want to be in the loop, make sure you subscribe and comment down your favorite part on this video. Again, my name is Shiv, a professional salesperson based out in Sydney, a public speaker, and a self-help content creator. I will see you all in the next video of My Uncooked Thoughts.